Polldaddy is an excellent app that turns your iPad into an electronic survey device. You can manufacture surveys using a PC or Mac and make them available to run offline using the iPad.
There are some really good survey apps and functions around. One of them you may have come across is SurveyMonkey. So it's surveymonkey.com on a web-based survey program. It's really good. You can do it on the iPad and a lot of other portable devices. But the benefit of Polldaddy is once the survey is on your iPad, you can actually collect responses when you're not online, when you're not in a wireless zone, and then upload them at a later stage. So first of all, I'll just show you the survey that I have made previously and used before. It's a test checklist, what I did right and wrong. And you can start the survey, review responses, or sync responses when you're connected to the internet. But for now, let's just do start the survey. So it has an opening page. You click start the survey, and you can put in name. We'll just do some initials for now. Done. Click next. And you can do different sorts of survey items. So you can do tick one column or the other. You can do multiple choice answers. You can do true or false. There's a whole range of different sorts of survey questions you can do, but I'll show you that later on. For now, we'll just go through and choose some of these quite randomly. Next, how well did we meet a particular outcome in the New South Wales syllabus? So effectively, okay, now we have some of those like it scales where you can have a number of categories. Yes, absolutely. Yes, moderately. Not sure. No, it was of little use. And no, not at all. So you can have multiple questions with the same criteria. And it's the end of the survey. So if we go back to the start, we can cancel out of that. It tells me I've had 4 offline responses with my survey. So I could actually go and look at the different responses I've had. I could review the responses, and this is response number 4. It tells me what the answers were for that person. So if your students did this, you could then get the results on your iPad, take it away, and have a look at where they did or didn't do well, depending on the survey you've set up. We click next, and it'll go to the other people who responded. Response 3, 2, 1. Once you're in a wireless zone, you can also sync your responses back to the website, and we'll have a look at the website now, how you set up an account. So to create surveys, you first need to go to the Polldaddy website, polldaddy.com, and you need to set up an account. So once you've done that, you basically log in, you have a username and a password. So I'll just sign in. So once you're logged in, you get to your dashboard screen and you can have a look at your surveys that you've made. You can do surveys or you can do polls. You can also do quizzes. So they're all slightly different. So let's make a new survey. You've got this Create a New tab. Click on the drop down and let's choose a survey. It'll take us to the survey options. We want to give this survey a name. Is Polldaddy good? Let's see if we think this app is actually good. We can select a style. Let's choose vintage. We can put a custom message if you want. So if you tick the box, you'll get to type in a custom message. Otherwise, you can untick it and leave that out. And then can have a progress indicator on your survey if you like. The other options, you can have the survey close after a certain date, or you can have it close after a quota is reached. You can choose a language customization. You can have multiple responses per computer or device, or you can just allow one response per computer. And you can have some other restrictions. You can do password protection, etc. So we've got those settings. Let's save those.